Hello, everyone. I am Professor Lee from Chungshan Medical University. Today, I would like to share with you the core values and purpose of University Social Responsibility, USR, at our institution. As an institution of higher education, we believe in taking from society and giving back to society. The purpose of our USR program is to promote sustainable development and be a responsible contributor to our local community. Through talent cultivation and local connections, we strive to understand the development context of our region, identify local issues, and propose innovative solutions that can make a positive impact. Our goal is to encourage our university to take social responsibility seriously, strengthen our local connections and partnerships, and guide our students to learn by doing. We believe in interdisciplinary teamwork and collaboration with local governments and industry to promote local industry clusters and community cultural innovation. By cultivating the ability of the next generation to understand and respond to real-world problems, we can foster a sense of local identity and stimulate ideas for local employment and entrepreneurship, thereby promoting regional innovation and growth.
希望透过我们自己在大学的专业知识呢，去解决台中市石冈区的长辈肌少症面临到的问题。样飞计划对于 EIR 团队，它其实就是一个摇篮，因为没有这个计划，就没有 EIR 这个团队。因为毕竟我们是算是同一个学校，不同系所，但是没有这个机会的话，其实我们要针对肌少症这个议题是比较难去下手的，对，就比较没有一个平台能够让我去发挥。我觉得样飞它算是一个很好的施展自己这个想法的一个很好的媒介平台。这样。
好，各位大家好，我是USR 子计划主持人郭清平老师。那我子计划的题目是轻盈共创孕育石冈。那在这个计划的开端基本上从我们开始盘点在地老人的一些健康议题为一个计划的开端。那发现在地老人的健康议题包括了就是有吞咽困难、营养不良，然后有虚弱跟肌少症的一些议题的发生。那也在我们评估的过程当中也发现了他们有一些睡眠的议题。那所以在这样的一个开端也引发了我们整个计划的一个初心。那所以呢整个计划开始的有这样的评估之后，那我就开始去做一些沉浸跟发想，那就开始在想如何去改变在地的一些这样子的一个健康议题，那如何引发他们改变的动机，还有在这些议题上如何去跟他们做蹲点跟培力的一个运作。那所以呢基本上在如何改变的部分的话我们就结合了本校特殊的一些医学院有的一些科系，包括医学、护理、营养跟复健等专业的一个照护的一个跨域连结。那在引发动机的部分的话，基本上在社区里面我们不以疾病为导向，而是融入了一些譬如说怀旧的一些童玩，然后歌唱跟发声游戏的一些环节的活动的设计。那借由这些活动的设计的有趣性跟他们的本身的一些经验的链接，那引发他们想要改变的动机。那在如何蹲点跟培育的部分的话，这几年来我们也着力在结合一些在地的一些社区资源，那甚至希望能够在我们离开之后也能够培育他们自己改变的一些能量。那再来在有了这样的一个沉浸跟发想之后，那我就开始去做一些规划跟实践的一些设计。那在规划的部分的话因为 USR 的计划的关系，发展了两个课程，一个是高龄学，一个是高龄健康促进。那所以呢在这些课程的规划之中，我们也让课程呢有了一些对接社区需要的一些成果的东西。那等一下我会一一做介绍。那再来的话就是希望在整个我们的场域的一个实践，那基本上我们是以这个石冈万安社区为一个我们实践的一个场域的一个运作这样。那首先我就来介绍一下我们课程的部分。那所以呢今天我大概会从课程跟成果还有场域实践这三个 procedure 跟大家做简介。那在课程的部分的话，基本上在这两个课程的一个主要的目标有这三个。那第一个就是我们希望学生能够以这个关怀老人为本的这个态度来提供他们食物的照护。那基本上我们希望在大学社会责任里面，尤其是我们在医学院的大学社会责任里面，能够让学生在未来他去体认到说整体老人服务的一个需求。那在这个部分我们希望能够让他们在未来提供老人照护的质跟量上面能够做一个提升。那第二个 目标的话，就是希望能够培养学生善尽社会责任的意识。那这个意识呢，希望他们能够延伸到说，未来他们在实际上临床上照护的时候，如何能够去除了这样的一个意识之外，如何能够采取实践的行动能力的培育上面做一些琢磨。那最后一个就是我们在台湾也不免俗的要去因应我们高龄化社会的来源。那所以在这个部分的话，我们希望能够提供高龄跨科系的一个整合课程。那所以呢，在这个课程里面，我们希望能够在跨域的这样的一个提供这个培育的课程当中，学生在毕业的时候能够顺利的去接轨，无缝接轨他职场要面对的这些老人，高龄的老人。那这个是我们课程设计的一个理念。所以以下我们在这几年来，在109年学年度的时候，我们大概以婚宴为主题。那因为我们在前面就做了一些在地的一些议题的评估，那就发现说吞咽困难跟这个最后的这个肌少症之间的一些关联性。那所以呢，长者在吞咽困难的部分的话，我们发现说部分的原因是因为他喉部的肌肉肌力不足。那所以我的课程就从这个吞咽能力的一个评估开始，让学生去学会如何评估你的对象的一些评估这个吞咽能力的一些问题，然后也借由一些比较不一样的设计，就是声乐老师来教导学生练习如何运用他的喉部肌肉的部分。那所以在这个部分的话，我们就会链接到说如何利用歌唱来训练他喉部的肌力，那进而能够改善，就是链接到改善长者吞咽困难的一些议题。那所以呢，这些照片就是我们会看到说有声乐老师进入课室来做一些这些肌肉的发声肌肉的一些训练的课程，还有就是芳疗的部分教导学生如何去链接说在这个肌肉放松的课程能够让这个肌肉的一个延展性能够提升。然后呢，还有就是进入社区里面去进行轻盈共学，把这样子的一个歌唱活动带到社区里面去。那在下学期的时候，我们就是在营养的部分我们去做一些铺陈。那在营养的部分的话，就是我们会发现说因为吞咽困难，然后长者不愿意吃东西，那会造成他营养的议题也会链接的去发生营养不良。那所以呢，我们就会从比较客观的，就是说随着肌肉跟脂肪的一个改变，然后会造成肌少症的这样的一个议题。所以希望从高蛋白饮食然后让学生去学习营养相关的一些学理。那如何从场域的长者他的一些拿手菜单，然后从这些拿手菜单去做一些分析，然后去了解说他们在营养上面可能在可以加入怎么样一个比较均衡的一个状态。那所以呢，在这个部分里面，我们就会有一些课程的配合，包括中药养生来入菜，还有就阿嬷的拿手菜等等。那把这些东西链接在我们营养的课程里面。那到了110的时候，我们再加入了一个就是睡眠的议题。那因为睡眠不好也会造成他的肌肉的休息度不够，那也会造成这个肌肉的一个流失的一个后果。那所以呢，多数的长者其实我们在评估的时候也发现他有一些营养的那个睡眠的问题。那所以我们透过量表的测试，然后让学生学会怎么样去评估长辈可能有睡眠品质的一些议题，然后也运用了 design thinking 的一些教学的模式，让学生去发想说哪些在长者助眠的主题上面他们可以做哪些介入。那所以呢，基本上我们除了课堂的一些培育，包括助眠的养生瑜伽，然后就是精油的这个制作然后到最后我们让他去应用一些 DT Design Thinking 的一个方式，然后去讨论一些助眠的主题。那把这些助眠的主题就是应用到社区场域去这样子。 那到了下学期的时候，我们就做了一个叫做轻盈共玩。那因为主题越多的情况下，然后会发现说，那怎么样比较用游戏的方式让长者去接触这样的讯息。那这个学期呢，我们就邀请了比较专业的桌游的老师，然后让学生带领着学生从无到有去设计出来总共四款的一个适合长者的一个桌游，然后结合卫教的内容还有趣味性，让陪着长者一起玩乐一起学习。那所以呢，我们依着这些议题的来源，也依着我们访谈的结果，那我们就带学生进入社区去做一些访谈，然后呢把这些相关的议题运用design thinking 的方式去讨论说，那我桌游的方案要如何设计。好，那再来就是设计出来的东西去做一些桌游的试玩，然后最终讨论出来设计出四款最适合长辈的一个桌游。那再来的话，我们上学期一的话，我们就加入一个叙事的概念，那就也会想象到说，我们怎么样去把长者进入课程的，让跟学生共学的这样的一个设计。那因为每个长者都有他自己的人生故事，那我们经由长者入课室跟同学共学的这样的一个学习模式，那培养出学生他的一个同理心，然后能够体验他就是长者他的一些生长的过程，他的一个价值观，然后进而反思自己到底能够把自己的所长能够发挥出来，然后展现一些同理关怀，那甚至他可以是一种就是自己的所长的提供，然后提供自己是一个志工的这样的一个概念，然后去为出发点。那下面这些照片是我们在场域去带的时候去展演自己人生故事的一个部分这样子。嘿，那所以以上是介绍我的课程的一个规划，那接下来就是重要的一个成果。那在重要成果的部分就包括桌游那我跟这个助眠设计的发想，还有长者的生命故事的部分。那所以呢，这是我们设计出来的四款桌游的一个样貌那这是借由叠叠乐来做一个卫教，然后呢，这个是利用一些小图卡，然后设计一些关卡，然后让长者去做一些营养的教学。那这个桌游的成果就是利用一些慢性病的部分就是糖尿病也是他们比较常见的慢性病的一些桌游的问题跟任务，然后让他们一一去做一些桌游的游戏这样。那这个是我们针对长者他们自己提出来的一些问题，就是他们对于他们的 Bupper Morpho 可能不太清楚，无法去做一些耐的联动。那我们利用桌游的游戏去教导他们怎么样去拼凑这些就是他们在手机上面去打字跟别人互动连通的这个技能这样子。嘿，那这是几款桌游。那助眠的这个设计发想的话，那学生就针对他们长者的这些议题，然后去利用设计思考去发想出来，就是说他们会发生的一些这个会干扰他们睡眠的，譬如说这有灯光，这有声音，然后或者是睡前的一些这个他们是认为是说看电视也会影响他们的睡眠的品质这样子。那再来还有宠物瑜伽可以帮助他们入眠。那还有的话就是有一些他们相关的白天的活动的设计的一些发想。那再来的话，这个就是宠物陪睡不累这也是他们想出来的一个设计发想。那这个是助眠设计的一个发想。那再来最后一个成果，就是我觉得比较有趣的是长者生命故事。那我们就邀请了四位长者进来学校里面，然后就是跟学生们做学习跟分享。那就有四位长辈，一个是发仔伯伯的一个生命故事的展演，然后还有一个琉璃翅膀。那琉璃翅膀这位女士，她是大陆的，就是先生是大陆人，然后她是客家人，所以在我们的文化背景底下，会有很多他们的很容易会折翼的故事，所以学生把它取了一个叫做琉璃翅膀，他们的一个发想这样子。 那再来的话，这一位大哥李大哥的一个投资人生，那当然这个投资人生就有很多高潮迭起、刻骨铭心的一些过程。好，那他们也分享给这个学生，好，编列他的生命故事。那另外一组的话，就是他们就是帮这个长者，好，这个大姐姐，她就选出来的一个题目叫做为自己负责的幸运。哦，那就是一个幸运，就是自主的好。那这个幸运就是他能够把全就是这个过程当中，其实他有很多他生命故事遇到的一些他无法自主的一个过程。那最终他抓到了自己一个 keyword， 就是为自己负责。所以呢，当他抓到这个 keyword 的时候，他在过他的人生的这个每个关卡的时候都能够层层的过去，所以他认为他是一个幸运这样子。嘿，那这个都是学生陪着长者想出来的一些故事这样子。嘿，那最后就是场域实践的部分。那在场域实践的部分，我们就是以我们最主轴的石冈场域当作我们的场域实践。那所以呢，在这个过程当中，你们就是大家会看到说，我们在这个石冈的场域，包括我们怎么样去评估啊，质量性的一个评估。那再来的话，就是把我们的成果带着长者去做一些展演，包括吞咽、歌唱这些议题。那还有就是我们会走入长辈的日常，然后就是有长辈就是走到他的家中去了解他整天的日常，那从这日常当中去设计出来他桌游的一些议题这样子。嘿，那所以呢，最后就是桌游的经营共玩。那这是几个我们在这个子计划底下完成的部分。那谢谢大家。
Hello everyone, I'm Professor Liu from the Department of Nutrition. The subject of Nutrition Department is establishing healthy eating capability through food and nutrition education. The content of the lecture will include introduction, aim, strategies, actions, and summary. For introduction, current nutrition status of Taiwanese elderly, according to the data from Nutrition and Health Survey in Taiwan, showed that both male and female with age above 65 years old eat insufficient calorie, vitamin D, vitamin E, and insufficient calcium, magnesium, zinc, and dietary fiber when compared to the recommended level. Dual effect of BMI on the risk of death in elderly was also demonstrated by the National Institute of Health. As shown here, both high BMI and low BMI increase the risk of mortality, the risk of death in the elderly. So what is the best BMI for the elderly? As you can see here, the lowest mortality occurred when the BMI of the elderly is between 25 to 26.9, which was thought to be a little bit overweight in general. And when the BMI is lower to be 22 to 23.0, which is within the normal BMI range, is actually a little bit increase in mortality of elderly, and get worse when the BMI is lower. And in the right hand side, as you can see, there are two curves in this figure, and the lower curve is represent normal people with old people with normal skeletal muscle mass index. The upper line represents the elderly with low skeletal muscle mass index. And when the BMI is between 24 to 26.9, the mortality of both group is quite similar. However, when the BMI is too high or too low, the people with low skeletal muscle mass index showed dramatically increased mortality. And that means if the elderly have too low muscle mass, no matter they are fat or not, overweight or underweight, they will have higher risk of death. So in the other hand, we'll show the data that to compare the elderly with frailty. I mean, the consumption of the food consumption of elderly with frailty when compared to diet guideline of Taiwan. It showed that these people eat much more stable food than recommended. But in fact, if we look inside, the more stable food that they eat is mainly represent too much refined carbohydrate food. And these frailty elderly also eat insufficient milk, vegetable, fruits, and fat. But again, if we look inside the fat they eat, the source of fat they eat, there is a lake of nuts and seeds. And according to this figure, it seems that these people eat enough protein and to at the same level to what was recommended. However, in 2022, the Taiwan government revised the daily protein intake recommendation for adults. Here, for people old than 50 years of age, the recommended protein intake is adjusted to be 70 for male and 60 for female. That means The elderly with frailty may also eat insufficient protein because after the revision of the guideline, food diet guideline, this blue bar will a bit increase, a bit longer here. So that will reflect the insufficiency of the orange one. So the aim of the sub-project is to promote healthy eating through food and nutrition education in relation to sarcopenia. And our specific aim are to benefit for people of the USR practice field, Shigang, and to benefit for CSMU students who attend USR courses. For the first one, we want to promote nutritional awareness of people to enhance the elderly's capability for aging in place and to nurture children's learning and talents for health and sustainability lifestyle in Shigang and inspire creative thinking for the application of local crops to prepare a healthy diet. For our students, we want to guide students to learn the needs of the public and contribute to Shigang with their professional competence through the field practice, and to let students feel what they were expected by the society for their expertise, and inspire the students to discover self-value and to recognize diverse possibilities in their future career. Nurture students' learning and talents of capability of cross-professional cooperation to help sustainable development of Middle Taiwan. So, what's our strategies and actions? For strategies, we want to carry our activity through cross-grade and through cross-department student group and the cross-professional teaching resource and cross-university partnership interaction by provide courses and train students to perform the field practice activities. The courses in the Department of Nutrition that were recruited into the USR project include practice of nutrition promotion, nutrition education, dessert making, and nutrition science for sports. And we recruit student associations to join in the field practice. That include Students Union of CSMU, Department Society of Nutrition and Students Project Team of Department of Medicine. And we encourage people in the practice field to join our activities. So far, there are many people had attended our activities. They include elderly in the community care station, volunteers of the community care station, students of the housekeeping class of Farmers Association, Shigang School students' parents, and Shigang School students. As to our actions, first, empowering health eating capabilities in young and old people of Shigang. For students, teaching with design thinking tool to inspire creativity of students to develop nutrition education activities with empathetic approach to arouse interest of school kids and the elderly. For people in Shigang, to cultivate healthy eating habits through nutrition education activities to school students and the elderly. We use MyPlate as an education tool to improve eating habits. MyPlate Smart Eating Formula is from the government of Taiwan. These are photos about CMSU students with Shigang School students in the left hand and with elderly in the right hand side. Two, delivering knowledge of nutrition need of the elderly and demonstrating food preparation skill for elderly with dysphagia. For our students, we teach students about how to design recipes for elderly to fit the recommended nutrients intake level. When preparing food for the elderly, dysphagia problem was also taken into account. For people in the practice field, 食纲, we demonstrate various skills for softening meat cuisine for the elderly, demonstrating several kinds of high-protein dessert with low-refined carbohydrates, giving lecture on health eating for the prevention of muscle loss. These are photos of demonstrating teaching materials for adjusting texture of meat by various preparation skill. And three, recombination of sport nutrition and physiotherapy for health promotion. For our students, we hold a co-teaching activity with sport nutritionist and a physiotherapist in a sport workshop to develop a resistant training set and made a film of it by students. For people in practice field, demonstrating the above-mentioned safe and efficient resistant training set in a company with sport nutrition lecture to prevent muscle loss of the elderly. We encourage appropriate exercise along with sufficient nutrients intake to avoid overweight, obesity, as well as to avoid sarcopenia. This is the picture about the resistant training program for elderly, combined with the desserts containing appropriate amount of carbohydrate and protein we demonstrated to the people in 食纲. And 豆腐汤圆 preparation is one of the examples. Rice bowl is a traditional food in 食纲. And traditionally, it was made from pure refined rice flour. And we lower the glycemic index and the refined carbohydrate in rice bowl by add the same amount of tofu to the dough, rice flour dough, to make the traditional food. This is welcomed by people in by old people in 食纲. 4. Communicating nutrition education activities with other universities via the production of films. For our students, students learn how to film well in order to record activities in practice field for discussion afterwards. These films are also a good resource for cross-university communication to improve the quality of our activity designing and to share our experience. And for people in 食纲, films of demonstration teaching are particularly useful for remote nutrition education for elderly in 食纲 during COVID-19 pandemic. These are some examples of the films produced by the students. Students are asked to make film of demonstration teaching and field practice activities as their homework. The 5, to inspire creativity to add value to local crop. For our student, we guide students to think about how to combine nutrition concept with Hakka food culture to improve balanced diet for elderly in 食纲 and to promote nutrition quality of local catering industry. And for people in 食纲, we developed a jam formula which combined local in-season fruit with pineapple to flavor sugar-free yogurt to promote the consumption of milk in elderly as a handy high-protein dessert. We increased nuts and seeds intake by recall a forgotten Hakka delicacy, Lei Cha, which is made from nuts, seeds, and dry tea leaves, and have to be grind to powder, before we can drink it. So in summary, Our sub-project is associated with SDG 3, 4, and 10. Being a medical university, CSMU plays an important role as a think tank of sustainable development of good health and well-being in Middle Taiwan. This sub-project takes our responsibility to the society by providing field practice activities on healthy eating issues. To eliminate discrimination in education, this sub-project provides nutrition education to people in rural Taichung and also to the elderly who often face certain form of discrimination in education because of the shortage of such resources. We all know that unequal health information deprives the opportunity of healthy aging for the elderly living in rural area. This sub-project provides current knowledge on sarcopenia and the prevention regimen for this population. The lecture ends here. Thank you for your listening. Thank you.
四十分钟
十超过。
还有牙结石呢，来，这边有没有看到？有没有看到？很可怕哦，它这边都会黄黄黑黑的。
Thank you.